Here it goes, Scotty. Arise and shine. Where's that air coming from? I can feel it. A draft. Oh, damn. Fools, where ahead? I got a good notion to report him. Serves him bloody well right. What's the use of blood in the ports if the dickhead goes and leaves them open, huh?
They don't see what the poor little light goes at just from the ports.
Don't be such a fool, Cocky. Do you not know the dangers of showing light to a little pack of submarines like this lying about these waters?
I don't think there's much danger of meeting any of their submarines. Not until we get into the war zone at any rate.
You don't, eh? Well, we're in the war zone right this minute if you want to know.
How do you know, Davis?
Because Drisk heard the first and the third below to wake the skipper and we fetched his own. About 5 bells it was. Now, what you got to say to that?
Oh, I wasn't doubting your word, Davis. But you know they're not pasting a bulletin to let the crew know when the zone is reached, especially on ammunition ships like this.
I don't like this voyage. Next time I'm going to ship one of the
British
jumpers
Navy blowing to hell in those submarines.
No,
they
wouldn't be done.
Shh!
Go. It's not only the submarines we have to fear, I'm thinking.
That's no lie, Scotty.
Do you mean the mines?
I wasn't thinking no mines either.
There's many a good ship blown up and at the bottom of the sea. What never hit no mine or torpedo.
Did you ever read of the German spies and the dirty work they're doing just to win the war?
And the clever ways they fool you. You just gotta watch out. That's all I says.
Ugh, this wrong coffee gives me a belly.
Stupid shit! Don't fret about that. If we blow up, you won't be minding the pain in your stomach, and that's for sure.
Hey, Bells, fellas.
I didn't hear any bells ring.
No. You won't hear any ring, you boo. Now we're in the war zone.
Is the boats all ready?
Sure. We can lower them in a sec.
A lot of good the boats will do. With us loaded deep with dynamite and stuff like that. If a torpedo were to hit this hooker, we'd all be in hell before you can even wink your eye.
They ain't gonna hit us, Z. That's my dope. Hell of a lot of use keeping a lookout. We couldn't run away or fight if we wanted to. You better look at the boats under the fork, you two of them see you're awake.
Captain, report, Duke. What's the matter with you? In a dope dream.
He's a queer fellow. I can't figure him out.
Nor no one else. And he's liable to turn out queerer than any of us think if we're not careful.
What do you mean?
I don't want to be caught in this hole if they hit us.
It wouldn't matter where you are. You'd be blown to smithereens before you could say your name.
Who's the dirty scum left this cup where a man had sit on it?
It's Smitty.
Does he think he's too much of a floaty gentleman like the rest of us to put his own away? If he does, I'm the boy who'll beat their notion out of his head.
And with the air he puts on, you'd think he was the Prince of Wales. What's he doing on a ship, I ask you? He ain't much of a sailor now, is he? Dawdling about on deck. Like a chicken with his head cut off.
Ah, the Duke's all right. Supposing he didn't get his cup, what's the diff? This war zone stuff's got your goat drist.
Yours too, Cocky. I ain't cheering much for myself, neither.
Climb here, ain't no bleeding joke. Your first trip to know there's a ship full of shells liable to go off underneath your blooming feet. Calls themselves human beings, too. Blasted Germans!
Since me last trip in the bloody zone, God help me. The divil take their 25% bonus. I'd be drowned like a rat in the trap in the bargain.
Wouldn't be so bad. If she wasn't carrying ammunition, them's the kind of subs is lame.
Don't be talking about it! I'm sick with thinking and jumping at every bit of a noise!
Hey, Davis. What were you saying about Smitty when they come in?
I'll tell you in a minute. I want to wait and see if he's coming back. He won't be calling them all right when he hears what I've seen with my own eyes. And he won't be feeling no safer neither.
God blast that.
I tell you, man. But it's clear outside like day.
Where's Smitty, Scotty?
Out on the hatch, staring at the moon like a man half-daft.
Can you see him from the doorway?
Aye.
so that. Keep your eyes on it for a moment. I got someone who wants to tell the boys that I don't want him walking the middle. Give a shout if he starts his way, huh?
I'll watch him. And I have something myself to say about his lordship as well.
Out with it. You're talking more than a pair of old women would be standing in the road getting no further along.
Listen! You remember when I went to go get this coffee, Jack?
Sure, I do.
Well, I brings it down here, same as usual, and got as far as the door when I sees him.
Smitty?
Yeah, Smitty. He was standing in the fo'c'sle there, looking around, sneaking like at Cocky and Scotty, as if he wants to make certain they're asleep.
Whatever.
Listen, he was standing right there, in his stocking feet, no shoes on, man, so he wouldn't make no noise. I knew right away something on the queer was up, so I slides back into the alleyway where I can see him, but he can't see me. After he makes sure the boat's asleep, he fishes in his pocket and takes out a bunch of keys, kneels down beside his case and opens it.
Man, didn't I see him do the same thing with my own two eyes? 'Twas just that moment I woke up and spied on the man.
Oh, you seen him too, eh?
Huh.
And Scotty will tell you if I'm lying or not.
And what did he do when he had the case open?
Well, he reaches out his hand, sort of scared like if it was something dangerous he was after. Then he starts feeling in under his duds and hit it in under his duds. It was, and he brings out a black iron box.
God, blimey.
Ain't that right, Scotty?
Right as rain. The man's telling you truth.
There you are. And then what he supposed he done after, huh? Puts the black box in under his mattress. In under his mattress, man.
And it's there now.
Of course it is.
Don't be touching it, Jack.
You need worry. Ain't no intention.
Is there all right?
I'm gonna hop out on deck. If fair gives me the tremble sitting still in here.
Are you frightened, you toad? It's a hell of a thing for grown men to be shivering like children at a bit of a black box. Still, it's damn queer the looks of it.
A bit of a black box, eh? How big do you think them things gotta be, huh? Big as this folks over here?
I bet it ain't enough, but some coin he saved he got locked up in there.
That's likely, ain't it? Then why does he act so suspicious? I mean, he's been on ship near 2 years, ain't he? He knows damn well there ain't no thieves on his fo'c'sle, don't he? And you knows as well as I do that he ain't have no money when he came on board, and he ain't saved none since. Don't you? Listen, you want to know what he done after he put that thing in under his mattress? And Scotty will tell you if I'm speaking truth. He looks around to see if anyone's woken up.
And I closed my eyes shut when he turned around and looked right at us.
And he crawls back into his bunk and shuts his eyes and starts snoring. Pretending he was asleep, man.
And I can hear him snoring as well.
And when I goes to call him, I don't even shake him. I just says, "Hey, Bill, Smitty." And almost whisper-like. And he gets up yawning, stretching, fit to kill himself as if he'd been dead asleep.
Blimey.
And now that I come to think of it, there's a portal. How'd it come to get open? Tell me that. I know damn well it wasn't Scotty. Ain't he always grumbling about being cold all the time?
The man who opened it, whoever he was, meant no good to this ship.
What poor hole? What are you talking about?
There! It was open when I walked in. I felt the cold air on my neck and shut it. It would have been as clear as a lighthouse to any subs I was watching. And we're supposed to have all the ports blinded. Who'd do a dirty trick like that, huh? It wasn't none of us. Nor Scotty here, nor Driscoll, nor Cocky, nor you. Who would it be then?
It must have been his bloody lordship.
For all we know, he might have been signaling with it. They does a lot that by winking a lot. Ain't you read how they gets caught doing that in London and off the coast?
Yeah. And what's he doing out alone on the hatch? Keeping himself clear of us? Like he was afraid.
Keep your eye on him, Scotty.
All right,
yeah. Do not move to him.
Ain't he an Englishman? What do you want to try to do something like that for?
How do we know he's English? Because he talks it? That ain't no proof. Ain't you read in the papers about all them German spies they've been catching in England? They've been living there for 10, not the matter, 20s of years. Talks English as good as anyone. And look here. Ain't you notice he don't talk natural? He talks it too damn good. That's what I mean. He don't talk exactly like a talk. Does he, Cocky?
Not like any tough either, man.
No. And he don't talk it like us. That's certain. And he don't look English. And what do we know about him when you come to look at it, huh? Nothing. He ever said where he comes from or why. All we knows is he ships on here in London about a year before the war starts as an AB. Stole his papers, most likely, when he don't even know how to box a compass. Hardly. Ain't that queer in itself? And was he ever open with us like a good shipmate? No. He always had this sly air about him as if he was hiding something.
Divil take me if I don't think of the truth of it, Davis.
I meant not be a silly air, you know. He's the son of a blasted earl or something.
And the name he calls himself, Smith. I'd risk a quit on my next payday that his name is Schmidt. If the truth is known,
y'all give me a pain. What they gonna put in the spy on this old tough boy?
They're deep ones. And there's a lot of things a sailor in seeing ports he puts in ought to be used for them. And if he can send them to him, and they blows us up, it's one ship less, ain't it? Or if he blows us up himself.
Hush, here he comes.
It's a good light night for the suds if there's any about.
Can you see him throwing the fiddles there?
He ain't half a sly one with his talk of submarines.
You see the sneaking looks he gave us?
If ever I saw black shame on a man's face, 'twas on his when he sat there.
Looked bad to me. He's a crook, all right.
What do we do? We gotta think of something quick, or...
It's only a piece of driftwood or floating log or something.
Or a mine that didn't go off that time. Or a piece of wreckage from a ship they sent to Davy Jones.
God blarg that. No man at all could be putting up with the like of this. And I'm not one to be fair in anything or any man in the world to stand up to me face to face. But this devil's trickery in the dark. I'll throw it out one of the portholes and be done with it.
Go! Monkey with it, Drisk! I knows what to do. Bring the bucket of water here, Jack, will you? And you, Scotty, see if you slow the hatch. Lift up the mattress, Drisk. Careful now. Take it out, Jack. Careful. Put it in the water. There. Easy. That's fixed it. The water will get in and spoil it.
Good work for you, Davis, you scut. And now, what's to be done with that black-hearted traitor?
Give him a shove in the mouth, and then heave him over the side.
And serve him right.
You can't prove none until you find out what's in there.
Is it more proof you'd be needing after what we've seen and heard? Then listen to me, and as Driscoll talking, if there's devilment in that box, and we see plain twas his plan to murder his own shipmates that have served him fair, I'll choke his rotten heart out with me own hands and over the side with him, and one man missing in the morning.
And no one the wiser. He's the balmy kind will commit suicide.
You know they ain't spies, they sure.
If he's done what you think, I'll croak him myself. Is that good enough for you?
How will you be open to this, I wonder?
He's standing up. Well, take his keys away when you walk
turning,
in. Quick, Trick, you and Jackie beside the door and grab him.
He's turning.
This will do for me and Scotty. Time up. Stand by and let it hang, Cocky.
Right, time.
If this is your idea of a joke, I have to confess, it's a bit too thick for me to enjoy.
Shut your mouth, you hear?
You'll find out it's no joke, me bucko, before we're done with you. Keep your eye peeled, Scotty, and sing out if anyone's come by.
If you'd be good enough to explain.
Oh, explain is it? 'Tis you'll do the explaining, and damn quick, or we'll know the reason why. Look here, you murdering swap. Do you see it?
Look at him! Surprised, ain't you? If he wants to try your dirty spy tricks on us, you gotta get up earlier in the morning.
Thought you weren't half a fox, didn't you?
What are you doing with my private belongings?
Private belongings.
What is it, you swine? Will you tell us to our faces? What's in it?
Nothing, but that's my business. You please attend to your own.
Oh, it is it? Talk easy now. If you know what's best for you, your business indeed, then we'll be making it ours, I'm thinking. Take his keys away from him, and we'll see if there's one to open it, maybe. Try to kick it over, would you? Did you see him then? Trying to murder us all, the scut.
Oh, God, strike me, Pinky! Kick me in the nuts! Oh! Bloody bleeding rotten Dutch oak! I'll show you what for you, bleeding.
Shut your mouth. You want to break the whole ship. We'll soon be knowing.
Cowards! Nicks on the rooftop! That don't get you nothing.
This will be it, I'm thinking.
Don't you open that box, Triss! If you do, so help me God, I'll kill you back to hang for it!
When I open this box, I'll not be the one to be killed, me sonny boy. I'm no dirty spy!
Spy? What are you talking about? I only put that box there so I can get it quick in case we were torpedoed! Are you all mad? You think I'm... You stupid curse. You cowardly dogs!
Hold it!
Cowards! Damn you rotten curs!
I'll shut your dirty mouth, babe. That'll teach you to be misnaming a man, you sneak! Have you a handkerchief, Jack? That'll fix your gab. And tie his feet, too, so he'll not be moving! We best be taking this to the skipper, you think, maybe.
Hell with the old man. This is our game. We can play without no help.
No bleeding officers, I say.
They'd only be taking all the credit, making heroes of themselves.
Here it goes, then.
Looks funny, don't it? Like a thin square tied up in a rubber bag, maybe? Maybe it's dynamite. Ain't got no works, so there ain't no bomb out there. They make some all kinds, they do.
Open it up, Drisk.
Careful now. Only letters. You're a hell of a Sherlock Holmes, ain't you? Letters from his best girl too, I bet. Let's say we turn to Duke Luke's. What do you say?
Don't be so damn smart, Jack. Letters, you says, as if there was no harm in them. How do you suppose spies get their orders and send back what they find out if it ain't by letters and such things, huh? There's many letters worse than any bomb.
Right, I'm. They ain't as innocent as they look. I'll take me oath on it when you read them. Not his lordship's letters.
Well, read them and find out then.
There! Listen to him! Look at him trying to get loose! Ain't that proof enough? He knows well we're finding him out!
Listen to me, Jack. Love letters, you says, as if they couldn't harm nothing. Listen, I was reading in some magazine in New York only 2 weeks back about how some German spy in Paris was sending love letters to some woman spy in Switzerland, who then sent them on to Berlin.
Germany! To read them, you wouldn't suspect much, just much and all, but they had a way of doing it, a damn sneaky way.
They take a piece of plain paper with the pieces cut out of it, and when they put the pieces on top of a letter, they reads only the words what tells them what they wants to know. And the Frenchies get beat in a fight all on account of that letter.
Blimey, they ain't our smart leaders.
And even if these letters of his do sound all right, they has what they calls a code. You can never tell. Read one of them, just my eyes is weak.
I'm no hand to be reading, but I'll try it.
He knows! Go ahead, Driss!
It begins, dearest man. And then there's a lot of blarney telling him how much she misses him now she's gone away to singing school. And how she hopes he'll settle down the real work and not be scoy larking around like she used to before she met up with him. And it ends, I love you better than anything in the world. You know that, don't you, dear? But before I can agree to live out my life with you, you must prove to me that the Black Shadow, I won't mention its hateful name, but you know what I mean, which might wreck both our lives, does not exist for you. You can do that, can you, dear? Don't you see you must for my sake? Love, Edith.
Yeah. What's the use of me getting this stuff?
Wait. Where's that letter from, Driss? What did I tell you, Driss? Postmark on the envelope.
The name that's written is Sidney Davison 100.
Never mind that. Of course, the boss name. Look at the postmark, Driss.
There's a fern stamp on it by the looks of it. The mark's blurred, so it's hard to read. B, E, R. The next is an L. I think an I and an N.
Berlin! What did I tell you? I knew them letters was from Germany.
You rotten hound.
Give me one of the letters, Driss. Maybe I can make something out of it. You go through the rest of the things out if you see anything queer.
I gotta give her up. This one's too deep for me. We'll turn him over to the pair at least when we dock in Liverpool. That one I got was written a year before the war started anyway. Find anything in yours?
They're all the same as the first. Love and Blarney and how her singing is doing and the great things the Dutch teacher says about her voice and how glad she is her Sydney boy is working hard and making a man of himself for her sake.
If only we had the coat!
Hello. Here's one address to the ship, SS Glencairn. It says when we was in Cape Town 7 months ago. That's from London.
Read it. Shut up!
Up begins with simply the name Sidney Davison. No dearest or sweetheart to this one. It is only from your chance meeting with Harry when you were drunk that I happen to know where to reach you. So you have run away to sea like the coward you are because you knew I had found out the truth.
The truth you have covered over with your mean little lies all the time I was away in Berlin and blindly trusted you. Very well, you have chosen. You have shown that your drunkenness means more to you than any love or faith of mine. I am sorry for I loved you, Sidney Davison, but this is the end. I leave you the memories, and if it is any satisfaction to you, I leave you the realization that you have wrecked my life as you have wrecked your own. My one remaining hope is that never in God's world will I ever see your face again.
What's that?
Bit of a dried up flower. A rose, maybe.
God, stiffen us. Are we never going to turn in for a week of sleep?
Oh.